Welcome to PCB Heaven Tech Labs. Today I will show you how the brushless motors are made. Now, before you see this video, make sure that you do know how the simple DC motors with brushes work. And if you don't, then I strongly suggest that you follow the link that appears on your screen. And there is a video there that explains exactly how the brush motors work. And it's important to have this knowledge, as during this presentation, I will assume that you do. Now, this is a 3D model of a brushless motor, and you can see the rotor of the motor. This is the base of the motor, and usually on the back side of the base there is a controller circuit. The brushless motors have this major drawback that they need a controller circuitry to operate. There is usually one controller chip and a couple of FET transistors or something else to control the power of the coils. Now, these two pins over here are the power supply of the motor. There are many types of brushless motors, others with two pins, others with three pins, maybe with four pins, but we will explain the simplest with two pins. Now, instead of taking one by one the parts out of the motor and explain them, I will rather do it backwards. I like this method. I will break completely the motor and start from the base, and I will build it part by part. Okay, so this is the base of the motor. This is a common base, actually. And you can see the holes for the coil wires. There are usually four coils, so we need eight holes. And in the middle there is this support piece. This is for the stator components. And also there is a hole through all this piece, and this is for the bearings and the shaft of the rotor. Now, the four electromagnets are fixed inside these four holes around this central piece, and in the middle, front and back, there are pockets for the rotor bearings. So I will start mounting the motor from these bearings. Now I will put the first roller bearing in front, okay, and there is another roller bearing in the back side. Yeah, okay, now the bearings are in position, and now it's time to complete the stator. The stator is actually composed from the four electromagnets, also known as the armature. They are fixed in a cross pattern like this, and unlike the normal brushed DC motors, the armature in brushless motors is not moving, and therefore it belongs to the stator. And this is the complete armature. And now we need the four coils. The coils are not winding in the same direction. I mean that two coils that are nearby will never have the same polarity, the same magnetic polarity. And therefore either their windings are reversed, or the current that flows within is reversed. Anyway, the stator is almost fixed now. You can see the wires from the coils on the bottom side. They go through the base. And also you can see a rectangular hole here. Now, this rectangular hole is for the Hall sensor. A Hall sensor is the component that make the brushless DC motors possible to operate. Actually, now if you want more information about the operation of the brushless motors, you would better follow the link in the info of this video. Just click the more info on the right side of this video and follow the link that you can find in there. Okay, now let's put the Hall sensor in position. It goes there. This is the Hall sensor. As you notice, it's between two armatures, and actually the geometric position of the hull sensor is very critical. It must be exactly in the middle of the two armatures. And all right. Now I put the controller PCB on the back side. This is the controller PCB. The stator is now 100% completed. Now for the rotor. The rotor on a brushless motor is fairly simple. Actually, the rotor carries only 4 permanent magnets. These 4 permanent magnets. And unlike the brush DC motors that have 2 magnets actually, they're placed in a north-south pattern, and the magnets along with the cover of the rotor can they move around the stator. And this is the great difference from the brushed motors. The brushless motors do not have any coil on the rotor, and they don't need any power to the rotor, so they don't have brushes. That's why they are called brushless, and that's the whole idea behind them. The lack of brushes means that, of course, great increase in lifetime, because the brushes are, as you know, something that wears off very fast, and that's why they are used in they're used extensively in applications that they need reliability. Now to complete the motor, I will place the shaft here. The shaft goes here. This is the shaft, and on the shaft the cover of the rotor is placed. Now this is actually, the motor is now completed. The permanent magnets are, as you understand, glued on the inside perimeter of the rotor cover. I will make it transparent so that you see how it rotates. Okay, and that's it. Thank you for watching this video, and don't forget to visit our website for more interesting projects.